Happy birthday, Grammy.
Happy birthday,
Grammy.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday, Grammy.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday, Grammy.
Happy birthday, Grammy. We love you.
Happy birthday, Ollie.
Happy birthday, Grandma. So happy we met you and we're blessed to have you in our lives. But I am going to beat you at Shanghai. It's going to happen. Coming. Coming.
Happy birthday,
Grammy.
Happy birthday, Grammy.
Is a blue shoots up through the stony ground. There's no room, no space to rent in this town. It's a beautiful day.
That was my super shot.
See the world in green and blue. See China right in front of you. See the canyons broken by cloud. See the tuna fleets clearing the sea out. See the bedlam fires at night. See the oil fields at first light. And see the birds of the leaving of night. After the flood, all the colors came. My sunshine, my only sunshine. You make me happy when skies are gray. You'll never know, dear, how much I love you. Please don't take my sunshine away.
In case you forgot, I'm your oldest son, Terry. And I'm here to wish you a happy birthday on your 90th.
Imagine 90 years ago today. Of course, 90 makes me 64. Who would have thunk? But what an awesome mother you've been. What an awesome day it's been today. And you know, what can I say? You are the best.
There are about 17 of us here right now waiting to tell some little stories about you. And we have so many stories. They're funny stories, they're happy stories, they're endearing stories, they're stories of love, they're stories of wonderful, wonderful memories. And all of those stories have brought us all here today because of you.
Happy birthday, Ollie. I love you very much. I can't believe it's your 90th birthday. You're not my grandmother per se, but you've certainly made me feel with as much love and caring that I certainly was one of your grandchildren.
Hi, Grammy. Happy birthday. Big 90. It's over 30,000 days. Thousands of smiles. Every time we come here, we have new stories, thousands of stories. Listening to them has always been a joy.
You've always been so good to me. Your family's been good to me and good to my parents. I love you very much, and I am so thankful that we could be here to celebrate your 90th birthday.
So great to see you and to have us all here together. We love you very much. Over the years, it's goes by like a blink of an eye, but you've always had so much love for us, so thank you for everything. And
I've been happy to have been part of your 80th birthday, now your 90th birthday, and I'm sure I'll see you at your 100th birthday, which will be a momentous occasion, I'm sure.
So, Grammy, happy 90th birthday. Sitting here in your lovely condo, it's absolutely beautiful, and you and I just won at Crib because we are the dream team. We pegged home.
Well, we're both here in Calgary. Want to wish Grammy a very happy 90th birthday. Love being out here and celebrating with her and all the rest of the family, and wouldn't want to be anywhere else.
Hey, Mom. This is a real privilege just sitting here doing this for you. You're an incredible lady, and believe me, I love you so much. It dawned on me the other day that it's 34 plus years since I first met you. Jack brought me over from Australia, December 77, and how you made me feel so welcome. I was never felt like an outsider. And that's just who you are and the type of person that you are, that you just love, and you love unconditionally. I love that about you.
Hey, Grammy, happy birthday, 90. You're kind of a big deal now. You know, you're up there. But I just want to say that all of us are so proud to have a grandmother like you. Over the years, you've been nothing but the most loving, supportive, amazing, funny grandma anybody could ever ask for.
Happy birthday, Grammy. I'm here all the way from Taiwan just for you. Wouldn't miss it for the world. We're all here for you, as I'm sure everybody has said. Because of a few things, because your kind nature, your wonderful, gentle smile. And if anybody could say anything, it'd be always that you love to tell stories and how wonderful and welcoming you are into the family.
You know, I look back and I just look at your two sons and wonder, how did you raise such fine athletes? The cheer of Troshu, I think.
Now back to T-Bone and Jack and their medal.
I think Troshu probably regales the stories of the swim meet back in 64.
Pretty much the first thing I ever heard that I can remember as an infant was about that dang medal.
I mean, I just remember them telling us stories back around the kitchen table when we were boys about their big meet, and they were damn proud of that bronze medal.
I don't know who won it, either T-Bone or Jack, or they shared it, or they just went back and forth with that medal, but
they were very good. Very good at sports too, you know, any sport.
But why swimming? Why were they that good at swimming? Like, they had I know there was a rivalry with Troshu and Three Hills, but why were they so good at swimming?
I'm trying to think.
Well, it was 1964, Troshu versus Three Hills yet again.
Well, we swam competitively, actually. It was right around Canada. We didn't stick to Three Hills and Troshu.
Jackie Boy and T-Bone in their yellow Speedos.
Who would have thunk? Who would have thunk?
We first went to Troshu, then we went up to Olds.
Just giving her across the prairies.
Then to Calgary.
You know, they knew they were the best in their own minds.
And as soon as we won all the championships there, we went on to BC.
I think they got a bronze medal. I mean, there's only three swimmers in their heat.
Hey, okay. Okay.
They were 17 and the other kids were in there. I think they're an 8 or 9 year olds.
Yeah. You got it. I don't believe it.
And then after BC, they shipped us over to Europe.
Yeah, front crawl through gravel, that's what they say.
And we did quite a bit of competitive swimming over there.
Very competitive within themselves, you know.
And I came home with, a bunch of good, really good medals.
I guess they were just good at it because they love swimming.
You know, they won a medal in swimming.
They had their swimming medal, their bronze swimming medal.
Shut rubbish.
By High hill, oh yeah, that's another adventure altogether. I tried to climb it about four times, and finally on the fourth try, I made it. I made it right to the top. I waved at Jack from the top, and he tried many times, but he couldn't make it either. But I was one of the only ones, actually, that really, really made it to Spy Hill, and I planted the flag. The flag's still there, if you look right in the corner there, and I don't think anybody else has been able to go over that cliff, so that's been an interesting thing.
And of course, before I leave, you can't leave without talking about the cinnamon buns. And of course, the halapchi, the petahare, you know, you name it.
You know that they called me pierogi boy as I grew up because obviously look at my belly. And I ate all your cinnamon buns and your pierogies, and you fed me well.
Whenever you'd come to visit us or we'd visit you in Calgary, and Janice would always say, Grammy, can we make some cinnamon buns? And I love to just stay in the background and watch the two of you.
I think probably the capper for me was when you told me that my pierogies were better than your mom's.
You didn't.
And so I think that was probably the best, how do you say it? Compliment? How do you say this?
You're one of the meanest Saskatoon pickers than anybody's ever known, you know.
Picking Saskatoon's a real adventure because they didn't cost us anything. They were wild.
I don't think there's anybody that can compete with you in picking Saskatoons or blueberries.
Actually, picking Saskatoons was more adventurous. Pick a few and eat a few and pick a few.
I'm pretty just a good picker. Like if there was a world champion fruit picker, berry picker, might be you. There's one thing that we've all been quite concerned about over the years, Grammy, is your language.
Well, if things go wrong, I just say, oh, sugar.
Your vernacular, it's some of the things that come out of your mouth.
Good gravy. Sparkle.
A little bit offside.
Yoy, 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 yoy.
Little bit offside.
Bugger. You didn't.
On the edge of, you know, what's that word?
Go ahead, did you say? Oh, sorry. Sorry. Hello.
Indecency. Indecency.
I've got so many, I don't know which ones.
What have you been using lately?
On the edge of indecency. No, it's just really vulgar, Grandma.
Shut the rubbish.
We've had enough of that biker language. Anyway, this is what I mean.
Well, if things go wrong, I just say, oh, sugar.
Oh, sugar.
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 Bugger.
No, in Australian. Bugger.
No, it's not Australian.
That's how your dad always said. Bugger.
Sugar.
Oh, bugger.
Bugger, sugar.
Good gravy.
Good gravy.
Good gravy.
Good gravy.
Is that okay? Do you want me to do it again?
Oh, good gravy.
No.
Let's move on.
Sparkle.
Sparkle.
Sparkle?
Sparkle.
Sparkle?
No.
Bugger.
You didn't.
You didn't.
You didn't.
You didn't.
You didn't?
What was the other one she used to say?
Shakti.
Shakshamaya.
Something rubbish.
Boozadobra.
Defining clobbits.
Is that one? Did she say that?
Oi, 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 oi,
oi. Oi, oi,
oi. Oi, oi, oi. What's the joy, 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 joy down in my heart? Where?
Do I need to do it again?
I just thought I would start off by saying, or singing, Happy Birthday in Portuguese, since I never got to do it in person, so here it goes. Parabéns pra você, nessa data querida, muitas felicidade, muitos anos de vida. Yay, happy birthday.
We all love you very much, and we hope you had a wonderful birthday and have many more to come, and God bless. Love you.
Anyway, Ollie, just wanted to say how happy I am that you've made it to 90. Appreciate all your kindness over the years and your acceptance of me for who I am. Thank you very much, and I wish you all the best and many more happy years to come. Love you.
Thank you so much for having us and us being a part of this. It's been wonderful and a great experience. Logan?
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday, Grandma. God bless.
Just wanted to say a big happy birthday, and I hope we're all together for many more.
But I guess for me, the most, I'll always remember your spirit and your sense of fun. To have that, especially when you're 90 years old, is amazing. I find your spirit is truly remarkable, and it's something that not very many people have. So I've always been very impressed, and whenever I think of you, I think of that smile and that generosity and that sense of spirit. So I hope you have a very happy birthday, and I love you very much.
And I just want to wish you a wonderful 90th. You're a special lady. I'm honored to be a part of your life. Love you heaps.
Love you very much. Love you so much. And thanks for everything you've always done. Thanks for all the love for the family. And we'll love you till the day I die.
We've known each other since I was 11. I remember you as my Sunday school teacher. I remember you as my friend when my mom went back to work. I remember you as my mother-in-law when Terry and I got married. I love you, and happy birthday again.
I know I tell you this all the time, but I can't tell you enough that I love you more than words can say, and I've felt lucky my whole life that you're my grandma. Happy birthday, Grammy. I love you.
You're awesome, and I look forward to your 100th birthday 10 years from now. Adios. Love you, Squillions.
Love you, and so happy birthday on your 90th. Your son, Terry.
We all love you. Gee, I made it to 90, and I got all these beautiful children here and everything. It was very, very touching.
It's amazing, isn't it?
It is amazing. We had a very happy time with our family. We had our ups and downs, and we had hard times. We didn't have much money, but we had a very happy family, yeah. I don't know, honey, how much time I've got or anything, but I know my time is in the Lord's hands. And every day is a good day because He's there helping me. And I don't get down because He gives me the wonderful outlook on life. Even when I was in the hospital, I said, I didn't ask when I was gonna go home, and I was there almost 4 months, and they couldn't get over the way I was so peaceful. And I said, well, this is the way it is. And I said, the Lord helps me with that. He gives me the peace. So I would say, I would recommend anybody to have a good faith and you'll have a good life. I felt very proud of my children. I did. And I thought, they're wonderful kids. And maybe somewhere along the way, I found a seed or two.